Hi, and thanks for watching. This video introduces sales and relationship managers and salespeople to the email logging feature in Dynamics 365 Business Central. To help you get control over email communications with customers and maximize their business value, Business Central and Exchange Online help you track email communications automatically in Opportunity Management. The three scenarios we'll look at are how to set up email interaction logging, how to set up the email addresses for salespersons and contacts, and how to turn on the interactions you track into opportunities. Let's dive right in to see how to set up email logging. The first thing to do is create a connection to your Office 365 subscription. Well, more specifically, to Exchange Online, which handles email communications. On the Business Manager Role Center, we'll open Assisted Setup and run the Setup Email Logging Assisted Setup Guide. We'll use our administrator account to sign in to Office 365. And then just accept the default settings on the remaining steps to finish the setup guide. Here's a little tip. To verify that our setup for email logging works, we can search for Marketing Setup, choose Actions, Functions, and then Validate Email Logging Setup. We can also schedule how frequently we want Business Central to log email interactions. To do that, we'll search for job queue entries and then set the recurrence of the email logging context adapter job to run more or less frequently. By default, the job runs every 10 minutes. On a side note, after we've started to log email interactions, this is a good place to look if we ever discover issues with the log. And that's it. We now have a connection between Business Central and our email in Office 365. Now let's move on to setting up email addresses for our salespersons and contacts. These are key for Business Central to track the interactions between salespeople and potential and existing customers that are of interest for relationship management in your business. We'll set these up from the Sales and Relationship Manager Role Center. On the navigation bar, we'll open the salesperson's list, choose a person to add an address for, and then enter their address. Next, we'll do the same thing for contacts on our contacts list page. Now we're all set to track email interactions. Any email exchange that happens between a contact and a salesperson for whom an email address is registered will be logged for the list of interactions. All you need to do is check interactions for a sales or contact person. That's easy. Just go to the contacts or salesperson's list, choose the contact or salesperson, and then choose Navigate, Salesperson, and then Interaction Log Entries. The Interaction Log Entries list shows all interactions that your company had with a potential or existing customer. There are a few things we can do from the list. If we spot an interaction that looks particularly promising, we can convert it to an opportunity and start the opportunity management process, which will guide us through a series of states in the sales cycle to complete the sale. To start that process, we'll choose the interaction and then choose Create Opportunity. If we're interested in seeing the content of a logged email, we can choose Show Attachment. Thanks for watching this video about how to set up email logging, which is great because it helps you manage, track, and record email interactions with customers in a consistent way. It also helps you turn recorded email interactions into business value by converting them to opportunities. Thanks again for watching.